effect transistors. Because of extremely high input impedance of JFET compared to BJT, it is used in many applications. Some of the applications are amplifier, analog switch, multiplexer, current limiter, voltage variable resistor, and oscillators. So we will see one by one the application of FETs. First one is FET is used as low noise amplifier, and it is also, that is common source, and it is also used as a buffer amplifier. Buffer amplifier, that is the common drain configuration. Common drain configuration in the sense drain is connected as a common between both input and output. This configuration, buffer amplifier configuration, is also called as isolator or unity gain amplifier. So when I say about unity gain amplifier, there is a somewhat confusion. What do you mean by the unity gain? So what is the use of unity gain? When you give 1 volt, and when you get 1 volt as an input, and if you get 1 volt as an output based on gain factor 1, then what is the use of it as amplifier? But buffer amplifier will work in the some other way, because it is connected in common drain and common drain configuration, and where current will get amplified, output current will get amplified. So what is the use of this one? Buffer amplifier acts like isolator. It will try to isolate, because of high input impedance and low output impedance, it will try to isolate the preceding stage from the following stage. So that is the use of FET applications as a amplifier. So now, what is the use of the FET? So one more application of FET is analog switch. In the diagram, you can see the diagram. So this is the circuit diagram. So when there is switch is open, then VGS is zero. When VGS is zero, this works like this FET or BJT works in saturation region. That means a closed switch. So when you close this switch, your negative voltage is applied. When you apply the negative voltage between VGS, then it acts like a open switch. The current is get reduced. It acts like a open switch. So that is the one more application of our FET as an analog switch. Third one, FET can be used as a multiplexer. In the diagram, you can see here various FETs are connected here, and these are control input. These are called as control input, V1, V2, V3. So now we know multiplexer is a device, electronic device, which will allow one of the multiple signal to the output based on the control signal. So here there are three input here, but based on the control signal, any one of the input is allowed to the output. So how this can be done? This can be done by the way, when you connect other input with negative voltage, that is when you connect this control signal with the high negative voltage, that is when you give negative voltage between gate to source, when you give negative voltage between gate to source, then this FET will be in the cutoff region. This FET will be in the cutoff, or it will not work. And based on this principle, you can allow the other input to the output. So this is one of the application as a multiplexer. Now the application of the one more application of the FET is a current limiter. What is a current limiter? Current limiter is the device which limits the current. For example, we use MCB in our normally in our house. What is the full form of MCB? MCB is called as miniature circuit breaker. It will allow to flow the current to the particular extent. For example, if you use 20 amps MCB, it will allow to flow the current till 20 amps. After that, the MCB will trip and it will protect the household device. So FLT can be used as a current limiter. Why? You see the configuration here in this configuration, VGS is 0, that is VGS is shorted. When VGS is 0, you know the curve output characteristics is something like this. This is VDS and this is VDS and this is ID, and output characteristics is something like this. So the current will increase to certain extent to the point that is called as IDSS. After IDSS, current remains saturated or stable. So that means it will not allow the current to exceed below IDSS. So this property can be used as a current limiter. This is one more application of our FET. So the next application of the FET is a voltage variable resistor. What is voltage variable resistor? Normally we use resistor in most of the electronic circuit, almost all the electronic circuits. So if you use fixed resistor, then instead of using fixed resistor, if you have a chance to use variable resistor by varying the voltage, then it would be better. So in this diagram you can see, so that you will take the characteristics of output characteristics of FET. So here output characteristics is nothing but ID versus VDS. This is the characteristic for VGS is equal to 0. This is the characteristic for VGS is equal to 1 volt. This is the characteristic for VGS is equal to 2 volt, minus 2 volt. This is the characteristic for VGS is equal to minus 3 volt. Now, we will take Ohm's law, important property of the Ohm's law. According to Ohm's law, V is proportional to I. This proportional constant is nothing but V is equal to IR. V is equal to I and R. So now this, if I plot using this graph, if I take y-axis current and x-axis voltage, my curve will be something like this. So at any point, if I consider this as a delta x and this as delta, sorry, this is delta I and this is delta V, then slope is defined by delta I divided by delta V divided by delta V. So slope is defined by delta I by delta V. Then from using this equation, what is I by V? I by V in this equation is nothing but 1 by R. So that means delta I by delta V gives 1 by R or R inverse. That means R inverse. That means if the slope is less, then larger resistance. If the slope is more, lesser resistance. If the slope is more, lesser resistance. If the slope is less, larger resistance. So in our curve here, you can see here slope is more, means resistance is less. Resistance is less. Here slope is a bit less compared to this one. So we will get a different resistance here. Here also we will get different resistor. Here we will get highest resistance because slope is less, means resistance is more. Here resistance is less. That's why large current flows here. Here lowest current flows. So you will get variable type of resistance. By using FET, FET can be used as a variable resistor. That is one more application of the
FAT.
So that is called as a variable resistor. So next application of the FAT is nothing but amplifier. FAT can be used as the amplifier because FAT will provide a 360-degree phase shift. That's why it can be, FAT can be used as an oscillator because FAT will provide a 360-degree phase shift. That's why FAT can be used as a oscillator. So these are the different types of the application of the FETs. One more application of the FET is nothing but something called as CMOS device, complementary metal oxide semiconductor device as an inverter. So this is very very important concept. How this is constructed? This is constructed by using two MOSFET. Here it is nothing but P-channel MOSFET on N substrate, and here it is nothing but N-channel MOSFET on a P-type of substrate. Both are interconnected. How it is connected? It is connected in this way, somewhat in this way. It is connected in this way. So the gate terminal of P-channel MOSFET and the gate terminal of N-channel MOSFETs are connected, and this is called as V-in. The drain terminal of both are connected, and this is we will call as V out, output terminal. Then source of P-channel MOSFET is connected with the connected to the substrate, and it is connected to higher potential. Source of N-channel is connected to the lower potential, that is ground. So this is the connection related to complementary CMOS device, complementary MOSFET, CMOS device. Now we will see the electrical circuit. This is the electrical circuit. So here you can see this is our P-channel MOSFET, enhancement MOSFET, and this is N-channel enhancement MOSFET. The gate of both are connected, and this is called as input, and drain of both are connected, and this is called as output. Other than that, we have connected P-channel MOSFET source and substrate to the higher potential, and N-channel MOSFET source and substrate to the lower potential. So now this is called as inverter. How this works as inverter? This is one more concept. How this works as inverter, we have to see. That we'll see in the next slide. So when here, suppose if I give the input, something like this. So if I give the input, this is 0 volt, this is binary 1 means 5 volt. If I give 0 volt, I should get invert of this one. If I give 1 volt, I should get invert of 1, nothing but 0. If I give 0, I should get 1. So initially we'll see we are giving here 0 volt. When you give a 0 volt, that means this gate and source becomes 0. This gate and source becomes 0. When VGS is 0 for the enhancement MOSFET will be in the cutoff region, that will not work. Enhancement MOSFET will work only when VGS crosses the threshold voltage. It will be in the cutoff region, it will not work. What about here? Here you can see this is 0 and this is somewhat, if you take 5 volt, then what is the VGS here? VGS is nothing but we know according to our previous equation, VG minus VS. What is VG here? VG is 0 and VS is 5. That means it works on minus 5. So we know from previous theory, P-channel MOSFET works on negative. If the N-channel MOSFET works on 0, if the N-channel MOSFET cut off on 0, then P-channel MOSFET works on negative 5. So it works here on the negative 5, and the current moves from here to here. So, but the current will not move from here to the ground. Current will not move from the gear to ear to the ground. So if you connect here one capacitor, this capacitor will get charged. The capacitor will get charged. For example, the capacitor will get charged, and once the full charge is done, then there is no current flow in the circuit because it is isolated. No current flow in the circuit. So power consumption is very less in this case. Static power dissipation is very less. So that is the use of this one. So what voltage we have given here? 0 volt. What we got is 1 volt. So now the second one is we will give here one that is logical one or 5 volt. When you give logical one 5 volt, this becomes a 5 volt, and this enhancement MOSFET will work. Enhancement MOSFET will work. Now it will be in the saturation region, it will work. But here what is VGS? Here VGS is calculated something like that: VG minus VS. VG is equal to, so this point 5 volt, and our VSS is 5 volt. That is nothing but 0 volt. That means now this transistor is off. MOSFET is off, and this MOSFET is on. Suppose your capacitor is, we have capacitor connected capacitor. We have one capacitor already connected during the this one charging cycle, and it has got charged something like this. It has got charged something like this. It has got charged. Now that charge will discharge through this path. Once the discharge is complete, then there is no current flow. So static power dissipation is very less. In this case. So this is the advantage of CMOS device. So CMOS device, complementary metal oxide semiconductor device, can be used for this purpose. So with this, students, you have completed the first part of your ADE, that is introduction to BJT and MOSFET, where we covered how BJT works, how MOSFET works, and rest of the things along with the application. In the next session, that is part 2, we will see introduction to operational amplifier. Thank you. Hello students, last class we have seen the biasing of enhanced MOSFET and depletion MOSFET. In this class we will see the different application of field effect transistors. Because of extremely high input impedance of JFET compared to BJT, it is used in many applications. Some of the applications are amplifier, analog switch, multiplexer, current limiter, voltage variable resistor, and oscillators. So we will see one by one the application of FETs. First one is FET is used as low noise amplifier, and it is also, that is common source, and it is also used as a buffer amplifier. Buffer amplifier, that is the common drain configuration. Common drain configuration in the sense drain is connected as a common between both input and output. This configuration, buffer amplifier configuration, is also called as isolator or unity gain amplifier. So when I say about unity gain amplifier, there is a somewhat confusion. What do you mean by unity gain? So what is the use of unity gain? When you give 1 volt, and when you get 1 volt as an input, and if you get 1 volt as an output based on gain factor 1, then what is the use of it as amplifier? But buffer amplifier will work in the some other way because it is connected in common drain and common drain configuration, and where current will get amplified, output current will get amplified. So what is the use of this one? Buffer amplifier acts like isolator. It will try to isolate because of high input impedance and low output impedance. It will try to isolate the preceding stage from the following stage. So that is the use of FET applications as a amplifier. So now, what is the use of Hello students, last class we have seen the biasing. Hello students, last class we have seen the biasing of enhanced MOSFET and depletion MOSFET. In this class we will see the different application of field effect transistors. Because of extremely high input impedance of JFET compared to BJT, it is used in many applications. Some of the applications are amplifier, analog switch, multiplexer, current limiter, voltage variable resistor, and oscillators. So we will see one by one the application of FETs. First one is FET is used as low noise amplifier, and it is also, that is common source, and it is also used as a buffer amplifier. Buffer amplifier, that is the common drain configuration. Common drain configuration in the sense drain is connected as a common between both input and output. This configuration, buffer amplifier configuration, is also called as isolator or unity gain amplifier. So when I say about unity gain amplifier, there is a somewhat confusion. What do you mean by unity gain? So what is the use of unity gain? When you give 1 volt, and when you get 1 volt as an input, and if you get 1 volt as an output based on gain factor 1, then what is the use of it as amplifier? But buffer amplifier will work in the some other way because it is connected in common drain and common drain configuration, and where current will get amplified, output current will get amplified. So what is the use of this one? Buffer amplifier acts like isolator. It will try to isolate because of high input impedance and low output impedance. It will try to isolate the preceding stage from the following stage. So that is the use of FET applications as a amplifier. So now, what is the use of the FET? So one more application of FET is analog switch. In the diagram, you can see the diagram. So this is the circuit diagram. So when there is switch is open, then VGS is zero. When VGS is zero, this works like FET or BJT works in saturation region. That means a closed switch. So when you close this switch, your negative voltage is applied. When you apply the negative voltage between VGS, then it acts like a open switch. The current is get reduced. It acts like a open switch. So that is the one more application of our FET as a analog switch. Third one, FET can be used as a multiplexer. In the diagram, you can see here various FETs are connected here, and these are control input. These are called as control input, V1, V2, V3. So now we know multiplexer is a device, an electronic device, which will allow one of the multiple signal to the output based on the control signal. So here there are three input here, but based on the control signal, any one of the input is allowed to the output. So how this can be done? This can be done By the way, when you connect other input with negative voltage, that is, when you connect this control signal with the I negative voltage, that is, when you give negative voltage between gate to source, when you give negative voltage between gate to source, then this FET will be in the cutoff region. This FET will be in the cutoff, or it will not work. And based on this principle, you can allow the other input to the output. So this is one of the application as a multiplexer. Now the application of the one more application of the FET is a current limiter. What is a current limiter? Current limiter is the device which limits the current. For example, we use MCB in our normally in our house. What is the full form of MCB? MCB is called as miniature circuit breaker. It will allow to flow the current to the particular extent. For example, if you use a 20 amps MCB, it will allow to flow the current till 20 amps. After that, the MCB will trip and it will protect the household device. So FET can be used as current limiter. Why? You see the configuration here. In this configuration, VGS is zero. That is, VGS is shorted. When VGS is zero, you know the curve output characteristics is something like this. This is VD, VDS, and this is VDS, and this is ID. And output characteristics is something like this. So the current will increase to certain extent to the point that is called as IDSS. After IDSS, current remains saturated or stable. So current remains saturated or stable. So that means it will not allow the current to exceed below IDSS. So this property can be used as a current limiter. This is one more application of our FET. So the next application of the FET is a voltage variable resistor. What is voltage variable resistor? Normally we use resistor in most of the electronic circuit, almost all the electronic circuits. So if you use fixed resistor, then instead of using fixed resistor, if we have a chance to use variable resistor by varying the voltage, then it would be better. So in this diagram you can see, so that you will take the characteristics of output characteristics of FET. So here output characteristics is nothing but ID versus VDS. This is the characteristic for VGS is equal to zero. This is the characteristic for VGS is equal to 1 volt. This is the characteristic for VGS is equal to 2 volt, minus 2 volt. This is the characteristic for VGS is equal to minus 3 volt. Now we will take Ohm's law, important property of the Ohm's law. According to Ohm's law, V is proportional to I. This proportional constant is nothing but V is equal to IR. V is equal to I and R. So now this, if I plot using this graph, if I take y axis current and x axis voltage, my curve will be something like this. So at any point, if I consider this as a delta x and this as delta, sorry, this is delta I and this is delta V, then slope is defined by delta I divided by delta V.
So slope is defined by delta I by delta V. Then from using this equation, what is I by V? I by V in this equation is nothing but 1 by R. So that means delta I by delta V gives 1 by R. 1 by R or R inverse. That means R inverse. That means if the slope is less, then larger resistance. If the slope is more, lesser resistance. If the slope is more, lesser resistance. If the slope is less, larger resistance. So in our curve here, you can see here slope is more, means resistance is less. Resistance is less. Here slope is a bit less compared to this one. So we will get a different resistance here. Here also we will get different resistor. Here we will get highest resistance because slope is less, means resistance is more. Here resistance is less. That's why large current flows here. Here lowest current flows. So you will get variable type of resistance by using FET. FET can be used as a variable resistor. That is one more application of the FET. So that is called as a variable resistor. So next application of the FET is nothing but amplifier. FET can be used as the amplifier because FET will provide a 360 degree phase shift. That's why it can be, sorry, FET can be used as an oscillator because FET will provide a 360 degree phase shift. That's why FET can be used as an oscillator. So these are the different types of the application of the FET. One more application of the FET is nothing but something called as CMOS device, complementary metal oxide semiconductor device, as an inverter. So this is very, very important concept. How this is constructed? This is constructed by using two MOSFET. Here it is nothing but P-channel MOSFET on N substrate, and here it is nothing but N-channel MOSFET on a P-type of substrate. Both are interconnected. How it is connected? It is connected in this way, somewhat in this way. It is connected in this way. So the gate terminal of P-channel MOSFET and the gate terminal of N-channel MOSFETs are connected, and this is called as V-in. The drain terminal of both are connected, and this is we will call as V out, output terminal. Then source of P channel MOSFET is connected to the substrate, and it is connected to higher potential. Source of N channel is connected to the lower potential, that is ground. So this is the connection related to complementary CMOS device, complementary MOSFET, CMOS device. Now we will see the electrical circuit. This is the electrical circuit. So here you can see this is our P-channel MOSFET, enhancement MOSFET, and this is N-channel enhancement MOSFET. The gate of both are connected, and this is called as input, and drain of both are connected, and this is called as output. Other than that, we have connected P-channel MOSFET source and substrate to the higher potential, and N-channel MOSFET source and substrate to the lower potential. So now this is called as inverter. How this works as inverter? This is one more concept. How this works as inverter, we have to see. That we will see in the next slide. So when here, suppose if I give the input, something like this. So if I give the input, this is 0 volt, this is binary 1, means 5 volt. If I give 0 volt, I should get invert of this one. If I give 1 volt, I should get invert of 1, nothing but 0. If I give 0, I should get 1. So initially we will see we are giving here 0 volt. When you give a 0 volt, that means this gate and source becomes 0. This gate and source becomes 0. When VGS is 0 for the enhancement MOSFET will be in the cutoff region. That will not work. Enhancement MOSFET will work only when VGS crosses the threshold voltage. It will be in the cutoff region. It will not work. What about here? Here you can see this is 0. And this is somewhat, if you take 5 volt, then what is the VGS here? VGS is nothing but, we know according to our previous equation, VG minus VS. What is VG here? VG is 0 and VS is 5. That means it works on minus 5. So, we know from previous theory, P-channel MOSFET works on negative. If the n-channel MOSFET works on 0, if the n-channel MOSFET cut off on 0, then p-channel MOSFET works on negative 5. So it works here on the negative 5 and the current moves from ear to ear. The current will not move from ear to the ground. So if you connect here one capacitor, this capacitor will get charged. And once the full charge is done, then there is no current flow in the circuit because it is isolated. No current flow in the circuit. So power consumption is very less in this case. Static power dissipation is very less. So that is the use of this one. So what voltage we are given here? 0 volt. What we got is 1 volt. So now the second one is we will give here one that is logical 1 or 5 volt. When you give logical 1 5 volt, this becomes a 5 volt and this enhancement MOSFET will work. Now it will be in the saturation region. It will work. But here what is VGS? Here VGS is calculated something like that. VG minus VS. VG is equal to, so this point 5 volt and our VSS is 5 volt. That is nothing but 0 volt. That means now this transistor is off. MOSFET is off and this MOSFET is on. Suppose your capacitor is, we have one capacitor already connected during the charging cycle and it has got charged something like this. Now that charge will discharge through this path. Once the discharge is complete, then there is no current flow. So static power dissipation is very less. In this case. So this is the advantage of CMOS device. So CMOS device, complementary metal oxide semiconductor device, can be used for this purpose. So with this, students, you have completed the first part of your ADE, that is introduction to BJT and MOSFET.